And speaking of tips, I'm reliably informed that what we're experiencing right now is spring, which means, hopefully, summer's not too far away.
Come on, summer. Yes, time to start thinking about making the most of the upcoming summer holidays. So Alistair's put together a couple of top tips to make your plans go that little bit smoother.
We've had a look back at the sort of holiday issues we've covered over the last couple of years and found some stories that suggest ways that you can save on money, but also the hassle. Starting with something that we know gobbles up a lot of the holiday budget, petrol.
The Fair Go team chipped in with ways to reduce our fuel use.
I think it needs about 36 psi in the front.
Make sure your tyres are inflated to the right pressure. This means less work for your car. Put your windows up so your car glides through the air without resistance. When you stop, you can put them down.
Lucky it's not too hot today.
Ah! I definitely do not need all this.
Try not to carry unnecessary baggage in your car. Remember, more items means more drag, which means more gas. If petrol prices are out of control, we can change gear on our driving habits.
If you've got something relaxing on, perhaps you're going to drive relaxing. I know with my own experience, if I put a bit of AC/DC on, I turn into a different driver.
Sorry friends, that means no pedal to the metal. Try to control your speed so you don't have to use the brakes as much.
Now, if you're thinking of going off-road this summer, camping or glamping or just getting out in nature, then you may already be thinking about what a terrible time you had last summer with that blow-up mattress, right?
Luckily, Katie's onto this one. Here she is.
Well, I'd say good morning, but I don't even know if I even went to sleep last night.
Katie tested three top airbed brands by leaving them overnight with weights on them. And then she tried them for real, also overnight. What a trooper. Katie's winner was not the most expensive airbed, it was the widest of the three. It's all about roll room.
I have slept right through.
But perhaps the best advice in the story came from a campsite manager.
Probably the most common mistake people make is when they store it, they fold it up and it's a hole put in it because it's been stored against the barbecue on the drive home sort of thing, and it's never used again until they turn up.
Probably the biggest holiday gripe we've had over the last couple of years has been about booking hotels and rooms online.
And finding out when we get there, things are not as they should be.
Oh, you've got to be kidding me.
So what rights do you have if your holiday rental turns out to be a dud?
By law, under the Fair Trading Act, accommodation providers cannot be misleading people about what they're actually promising and what is in fact delivered.
But Consumer New Zealand's Gemma Rasmussen says people need to be reasonable.
If you're looking at a completely different setup from the photo that has been represented to you, or the house is a lot dirtier, then you do have grounds for complaint.
So here's some options if things go wrong.
Contact the owner or host straight away, and if that doesn't work, get in touch with the third party you booked with as soon as possible, and take lots of photos as proof.
As a last resort, there is the Disputes Tribunal, or if you're fast, you can get a chargeback from your bank.
And you might be able to save yourself some grief by reading the listing carefully and asking the host all the right questions before you book. So that's it, and
fingers crossed, the weather turns out.
So it's all about checking this week. Do your due diligence.
That's right.